Good morning. Not my forte, so I hope it's good.
Hey, Daryl, go get them.
Let me start off with saying thank you. My church family, my friends, awesome support that lets me do things like this. When we think of Africa, this is what I thought of. These pictures are all taken by me on vacation a year ago. This was Africa to me, and it is to most of us. And then I saw a Facebook ad. A friend of mine posted this 2 years ago that we needed help. They needed an OR nurse, and that's what I do. So I responded. It took about a year and a half to actually go, but God does weird stuff, even through Facebook. So you finally get to the ship, and it's like overwhelming. If you look at that gangplank there, there's a man standing at the top. First, you have to carry your luggage up there. Okay, so you can see how big that is. These are little glimpses of the ship. They have a deck on top, a lot of stairs, a lot of corridors, a lot of stairs, a lot of corridors with people in. This is my room. You get that tiny little space, and that's you share it with six other people. So community is a big thing. So if you look in the picture on the left, down behind that van, you see that little bumper that protects the ship from the dock. So on the right, that's me standing beside those bumpers. That gives you an idea of the size of this floating city. This was my favorite thing. On the left, it says escape route, and there's a jail right beside it. I have no idea what that was, but here's a glimpse of the cafe, the family, the meeting rooms, the social areas, playgrounds, exercise equipment, all kind of stuff. The pool on the top deck. It was a container truck. They turned it into a swimming pool. And then you look out the window from your dining room, and you see that woman up close, but that's her walking on the dock. That's where the patients come from. They meet out there. They have tents for pre-op. They have tents for rehab. They have tents for everything. And that's how they get there. They walk. They walk everywhere. Then we finally get to the operating room. Week one, I did eye surgery. Very cool. I am not an eye surgery person. Didn't matter. They teach you how to do it. They teach you what you need to know. And the first week, we did more than 50 cataracts. And the pterygiums are when the growth goes over their eyes. We did several of those, and that each week was that. And at the end of the week, they have a celebration of sight for the people who had gone the weeks before and they can see and they couldn't, because their cataracts get really bad, not like here. In the celebration of sight, in three languages, they talk to these people about how Jesus restored sight to the blind man.
Amen.
And the people, they make them participate. You know, it's interactive with them, and it is an awesome experience. People are mostly Muslim here, and people come to know Jesus through this ministry. They do two patients in the room at the same time. People would balk at that here, you know? And that was my group for the eye people. There's, I'd say, at least five or six countries represented in that small group. Week two was women's health. If you get a chance, go to YouTube and watch A Walk to Beautiful. There's no charge for it. It explains the horrible life that these women have. Look it up. Watch it. It's free. It's an eye-opener. If you look there at that ball, those are women that have had the reconstructive surgery these women need. It's life-changing for them. They are ostracized from their communities. They lose their families, their husbands, some 15, 20 years. Now look at the faces as they come closer. You see one thing on all of them. Joy. Yeah. And this wall is in that area I showed you, the community room. They add to it every service. The week that I got to go, they have what's called a dress ceremony. And these women come out in new outfits. They are dressed to the nines. They radiate joy. They share their stories. Two on the eight that I saw, their husbands were still there. The other ones have been ostracized for 15, 18, 20 years. Something we can't imagine here. Week three was Max Facts, as they call it. What's the big things that you think about in Africa? We are not allowed to take pictures. So the pictures I have may not be the people that you helped directly, but they are similar to the ones that you helped. So we'll see more of this a little later. They have other ministries. They have dentistry. They have they teach surgeons in the area to do these things so they can help their own people. It's not about just doing and leaving. It's about leaving it better than when you came. And they're very big on that. And then you look around, and this is the Africa I saw. All kinds of people, manual labor. There's no business like we see here. There's no minimum wage. If they get paid a dollar for their day, they're happy. They're doing well. There's trash. There's homelessness. You can see the housing conditions. They're poor. It's the picture on the right is the hospital on the island that we visited. That's the hospital. It wasn't clean. It wasn't sanitary. And it was a bed, a nursery bassinet, and a refrigerator with a lock and a bolt on it, because that was the only electricity on that half of the island. This is where people live. This is what you see. That's the good home. This is the children gathering water, because they don't have running water. They go get it. This is, if you look, some of them don't even have a house. Now, if you look, the one on the right is fine dining. That's their fancy restaurant for their everyday person. Yes, it's as bad as it looks. And on the left, it's a gathering at another fancy restaurant we went to, as you can see. There's a little girl in the middle. We thought she was coming to visit. Here, her mom wanted her to go smile at us and be nice and collect money. That little girl was working, and that happens all the time. This is the OR hallway. We got to worship together every Tuesday morning. They had music, they had singing. Didn't matter what country you were from, you got to worship together before you started your day. And every morning, we had report on all of our patients, and you prayed for each one. You prayed for each person in the room. You prayed for each patient that was going to be operated on that day. We don't do that here. That's almost a crime most places here. That was beautiful. And then there was worship every night. You could go to worship services. There were small group Bible studies. It's a Christian ship with a lot of Muslims working on it. And in peace and in harmony. There was nothing like you see in our country. The day crew, the people that would come and work during the day as translators and things like that, many of them, by the next field service, had given their hearts to Christ and worked as crew, not day crew. And it was amazing to see. And their testimonies are just fascinating. Another morning of worship. We had song sheets. We had a preacher. Then this is Palm Sunday on the ship. Notice the palm fronds. They go above and beyond. This guy here is one of the day crew turned preacher. His name is Phil. If you guys want to pray for Phil, he would love it. This is Easter Sunday sunrise service on the ship. It was beautiful. Not that our services here aren't awesome. They are. But it's not the same, you know? It's a whole bunch of people that don't know each other worshiping God. This is family. That's a different kind of family. The girl in the upper picture, I know one person that lives in one city in Virginia, I believe it is. That is her track coach. Small world story. Huh. We were roommates. Huh. Talk about random. You know? That's me hard at work. And that's the end of that portion. There's a couple of things I wanted to tell you. We were gated. We are protected when we're there, except that we watched people get bribed every day. So they'd walk in, the women would hand the money to the guards and just come in. So yeah, we're protected, but not really. The people in the community, they loved us. We went to the island to visit, and a guy greeted us and said, "Hey, I'm your guide." Oh, we didn't hire a guide because everything costs money. And he said, "No, you take care of my people. I take care of you." And that was their attitude. All of the time. The best thing I can take away from this experience is, one, you guys are awesome. And two, living in a place where there are Christians all around you, and just soaking that in for 3 weeks is amazing. If you get the opportunity, there are 400 jobs on that ship. 3 of them are paid. Very few of them are nursing. So you can cook, you can clean, you can do laundry, you can do all kind of things. So if you get the opportunity, go to their website, check out the job list, and see maybe it's something that you can do as well. Thank you all.
It's a mama singing songs about the Lord. It's a daddy spending family time the world says he cannot afford. These simple moments change the world. It's a pastor at a tiny little church. 40 years of loving on the broken and the hurt. These simple moments change the world. Dream small. Don't buy the lie, you've gotta do it all. Just let Jesus use you where you are. One day at a time, live well. Loving God and others as yourself. Find little ways where only you can help. With His great love, a tiny rock can make a giant fall. Dream small. Special needs. These simple moments change the world. Of course, there's nothing wrong with bigger dreams. Just don't miss the minutes on your way to bigger things. No, 'cause these simple moments change the world. So dream small. Don't buy the lie, you've gotta do it all. Jesus, use you where you are. One day at a time, live well. Loving God and others as yourself. Find little ways where only you can help. With His great love, a tiny rock can make a giant fall. So dream small. Keep loving, keep serving, keep listening, keep learning, keep praying, keep hoping, keep seeking, keep searching.